Oh,
God. I think we caught the bear there.
Yeah.
At this point, all I'm trying to do is not lose my breakfast. So this is me, Gavin Hardcastle, and I'm a very professional photography instructor from Vancouver Island, BC. This is Tania. She's a professional truck driver, and she's got the skills to get us where we need to be.
Does this thing have shock absorbers? It doesn't have any shock.
No.
Zero.
I think we just broke something.
Really?
But the gate might be locked.
Notice the gate's open.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Ah, well, I got that one wrong. We needed to get past this gate so that we could get to this waterfall I wanted to shoot. Somehow, Tania had a key that works on some of these gates, so we gave it a try. Well, try as we might, we could not open this lock, and it was looking like we were going to have to crack out Plan B. And Plan B, well, that involved us getting the Bronco across a muddy swamp.
Yeah? I'm going to be so impressed if this works.
If this works, okay, but if we get stuck...
Then what?
Well, my mom has a truck down the road.
Okay.
And she's done it. I've got to say, I was pretty impressed. This would have been a very short video if we hadn't been able to get past this gate. The adventure continues.
I'm so impressed with Tania right now. She got us places where we otherwise wouldn't have been able to get without the glory of the Bronco.
Right.
Has the Bronco got a name?
Actually, it's called Britney.
The Bronco is called Britney.
Britney, yeah.
That's brilliant. That's actually genius. It's like, I'd say 2 feet.
2 feet? That looks like a 4 foot drop there, bud.
What do you think, Tania? Can we cross this river?
I'm thinking we can pretty much do anything we put our minds to. It's f***ing deep.
Do you want to bail?
After all of that fun, it was time to get down to business. Seeing as we were chasing light rays, we needed to get into the canyon quick sharp to catch the right angles of light. This is the spot that Caden and I tried to reach a few weeks earlier in my last video, but it was just too sketchy hiking up the swollen river. Today, however, the conditions were absolutely perfect for getting to the top waterfall with just the right amount of water. All we had to do was not break our ankles. God, when did I get so bow-legged? Tania was just loving those gorgeous green colours, and now it was finally time to get taties deep in the white stuff. It's always a good idea whenever you're hiking up a river like this, make sure you put your phone in either your waterproof jacket or your camera bag, because if you leave it in your pants, it's probably going to get drowned. After we cleared the logjam of doom, there was one last section of deep water to get through. Our goal was almost in sight, just around this final corner.
Beautiful. So I think this is it. I think this is the last bowl and we're in. You coming?
Yeah, I'm going this way.
So the moment of truth has finally arrived. Will it be worth all of the effort, soggy feet, and shriveled unmentionables? Well, just have a look at this business. Oof. So just in case you couldn't tell, light rays are like gold for landscape photographers.
The waterfall was perfect, the water level was fantastic, and we even got light rays, so I got a good shot. Did you get a good shot?
Yeah, I got a good shot.
So we'll see. We'll compare the two. Beginner camera, beginner shooter, pro camera, see which one is best. See you in a bit.
So this is Tanya's shot, and to be honest, I think it's better than mine, I've got to say. Tanya's a complete beginner, and she's got a beginner's camera, and I'd love to take some of the credit for this because I did teach her how to shoot waterfalls, but really I can't. All of the credit goes to Tanya because she got herself in the right position, she created a good composition, and she used good technique, so good job, Tanya, good job. So with a few good shots in the bag, we head downriver to go back to Britney the Bro. And I go for a dive. What an absolute shambles. Camera bag in the water and everything. Thank God I put my phone in my waterproof jacket. Whew. After an hour of freezing cold waters, we were looking forward to warming up. Little did we know, we were in for a cold afternoon. Another top tip is to always bring along some sandals or flip-flops so that you can peel off your soggy hikers and socks and just slip into something comfortable. Oh.
So Tanya, do you reckon you can get us back across that mud pit?
I sure hope so.
Let's do it!
We soon realised though that the problem was not going to be the mud pit.
Sucked in some water. Did we go in very deep?
2 feet deep.
Well, after all that we'd overcome, we finally got bested by Nile Creek. We spent hours under the hood trying to fix the problem, but Britney the Bronco would not start again, and we had to hike out of the forest. Still, at least we got the shots we came for, and that's all that matters, right? Right? Well, I've got to tell you that Britney the Bronco did not make it out of the forest that night. We had to leave her by the riverside and she got towed out of there the very next day, which was a complete fiasco in itself. But anyway, we got some great pictures and some good footage, had a great time. Really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please hit the like button, and even better, subscribe to my channel. Help me to keep this channel going. My name's Gavin Hardcastle from Fototripper.com. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.